deposited, that is the assessing Mr. Ram deposited Rs 90,000 in PPF, that is Public Provident Fund, Rs 20,000 in RPF, that is Recognized Provident Fund. So these two contributions are eligible for deduction under Section 80C. And pay tuition fee of his son Rs 18,000. So tuition fee paid for his son is also eligible for deduction under Section 80C. He deposited Rs 25,000 in Pension Fund of LIC of India. So deposit in Pension Fund of LIC of India is eligible for deduction under Section 80CCC. He paid interest Rs 15,000 on loan taken from financial institution for his higher education. So this interest on loan is eligible for deduction under Section 80E. And regarding deduction, the amount of interest actually paid can be claimed as deduction. We are asked to compute his total income for the assessment year 2019 to 2020. Let us look at the answer for this problem. Taxable income from salaries rupees 7,65,000. So this is the only income, taxable income given in the problem, and this taxable income from salaries is taken as the gross total income. From the gross total income, we are going to allow deductions under Section 80. So first one is contribution to Public Provident Fund as per Section 80C. The amount so paid can be claimed as deduction, that is 90,000. And next one is contribution to RPF, that is Recognized Provident Fund, Section 80C, 20,000. Tuition fees for his son, again Section 80C, 18,000. Pension Fund of LIC, Section 80CCC, Rs. 25,000. And total amount of deductions claimed under Section 80C and 80CCC comes to Rs. 1,53,000. According to Section 80CCE, the maximum limit an individual can claim as deduction is Rs. 1,50,000. But in our problem, the total amount of deduction comes to Rs. 1,53,000. So we are restricting the amount of deduction to 1,50,000. It is 1,50,000 or 1,53,000, whichever is less. We are restricting the amount of deduction to 1,50,000 as per Section 80CCE. The next one is interest on loan taken for his higher education, for his own higher education. And this amount of interest on loan taken for a higher education can be claimed as a deduction under Section 80E. And regarding the amount of deduction, the amount actually paid can be claimed as deduction, which is 15,000. So total amount of deductions that can be claimed is Rs. 1,65,000. Deduct 1,65,000 from the gross total income 7,65,000. The total income of the assessee comes to Rs. 6 lakhs. Gross total income of S is Rs. 6,75,000. She deposited in RPF Rs. 50,000, which is Recognized Provident Fund. So this 50,000 can be claimed as deduction under Section 80C. She paid a donation to a political party Rs. 10,000 by cheque. That is, the assessee is paying a donation to a political party by means of cheque, and the amount is Rs. 10,000. In this problem, the assessee is an individual. So she can claim deduction for this donation under Section 80GGC. And regarding the amount of deduction, the amount paid by the assessee can be claimed as deduction. It is 100% deduction. And Prime Minister National Relief Fund Rs. 15,000 by means of cheque. So an assessee, that is Mrs. S, is the, giving donation to Prime Minister National Relief Fund Rs. 15,000 by means of cheque. So for this donation, she can claim deduction under Section 80G. And this comes under the category of without limit. And regarding the amount of deduction, 100% deduction can be allowed as deduction for this amount of donation. She also paid medical insurance premium on the health of her spouse, aged 47 years. So her spouse is not a senior citizen. Rupees 27,000 by check. So the assessee is paying medical insurance premium of 27,000 on the health of her spouse, and age of the spouse is 47 years. So he will not come under the category of senior citizen. Regarding this payment, the assessee can claim deduction under section 80B, and the maximum limit that can be claimed as a reduction in this case is rupees 25,000. Compute her total income for the assessment year 2019-20. Let us now look at the answer. Gross total income of the assessee is 6,75,000. From the gross total income, we are deducting the deductions under section 80. The first one is deposit in RPF, section 80C, 50,000. The next one is donation to a political party. As per section 80GGC, she can claim full amount as deduction, which is 10,000. The next one is donation to Prime Minister National Relief Fund. She can claim deduction under section 80G. And this deduction comes under the category of without limit, and the percentage of deduction is 100%. So full amount of 15,000 can be claimed as deduction. The next one is contribution to medical insurance premium. That is, she has paid rupees 27,000 by check, but according to section 80D, the maximum limit she can claim is only 25,000. So only 25,000 is claimed. Amount of deductions comes to 1 lakh, and deduct this 1 lakh from the gross total income 6,75,000. The total income of the assessee comes to rupees 5,75,000. Business income of Mr. X, aged 70 years, is rupees 13,20,000. He deposited rupees 70,000 in PPF, that is Public Provident Fund, and purchased NSC 8th issue rupees 50,000. So both these payments are qualified for, are eligible for deduction under section 80C. He paid interest on loan from financial institution for higher education of his grandson rupees 1,20,000. So this amount is eligible for deduction under section 80E. It is payment of interest on loan taken from financial institution for education purpose of the assessee or his spouse or children. Only for these persons the assessee can claim deduction. The assessee can't claim deduction for his grandson, for interest on loan paid for his grandson's higher education as per section 80E. He spent rupees 40,000 on medical treatment of disabled dependent. So he is spending rupees 40,000 on medical treatment of a disabled dependent. So for this payment, the assessee can claim deduction under section 80DD. We are asked to compute his total income for the assessment year 2019-20. Let us look at the answer. Business income, being the gross total income of the assessee, is rupees 13,20,000 less deductions under section 80. Number 1, deposit in PPF, that is Public Provident Fund, section 80C, 70,000. Purchase of NSC 8th issue, again section 80C, 50,000. So in case of 80C, actual amount paid or rupees 1,50,000, whichever is less can be claimed as deduction. So add up both these two items, 70,000 and 50,000. The total of these deductions comes to rupees 1,20,000, which is less than rupees 1,50,000. So the full amount of 1,20,000 can be claimed as deduction under section 80C. The next one is interest on loan for higher education of grandson. So according to section 80E, the assessee can claim deduction for interest on loan taken for higher education, either for his own higher education or for his spouse's higher education or for his children's higher education. Here, he has paid interest on loan for the higher education of his grandson. So, he can't claim deduction under section 80E. The next one is medical treatment of disabled dependent. So, he is spending rupees 40,000 for medical treatment of a dependent, disabled dependent. So you can claim deduction under section 80DD. So in case of disability, the the amount, standard amount of deduction that can be claimed under section 80DD is rupees 75,000. Even though the assessee has spent only rupees 40,000, he can claim rupees 75,000 as deduction. Now add up these two deductions, 1,20,000 plus 75,000 comes to 1,95,000. Deduct 1,95,000 from 13,20,000 to get the total income of 11,25,000. The next problem is salary of Mr. Y, a disabled, is rupees 4,80,000. So here the assessee is a disabled person, so he can claim deduction under section 80U. And moreover, here only the salary is given, gross salary is given, so we have to make deductions. The next one is, he deposited rupees 20,000 in unrecognized provident fund. So deposit in unrecognized provident fund can be claimed as deduction as per section 80C. The next one is, he paid life insurance premium on a policy of rupees 45,000 issued on 15/6/2013 of rupees 4 lakhs. So life insurance premium paid by the assessee is 45,000. The policy amount is 4 lakhs and the policy is issued on 15/6/2013. That is, the policy is issued on or after 1/4/2012. The next one is, he donated rupees 20,000 to National Children's Fund by check. So donation to National Children's Fund is eligible for deduction under section 80G. We are asked to compute his total income for the assessment year 2019 to 2020. Let us now look at the answer. We are given only gross salary of the assessee. It is 4,80,000. From the gross salary, allow deduction under section 16. That is, standard deduction of rupees 40,000. Transferable salary is 4,40,000. From this 4,40,000, we are going to allow deductions under section 18. The first one is deposit in unrecognized provident fund. So as I told you earlier, deposit in unrecognized provident fund will not qualify for deduction under section 18C. The next one is life insurance premium paid on the policy taken on 15/6/2013. Since the policy is taken on or after 1/4/2012, the amount of deduction that can be claimed is actual amount of insurance premium paid or 10% of the policy amount, whichever is less. So actual amount of premium paid is 45,000 or 10% of the policy amount. The policy amount is 4 lakhs. So 10% of 4 lakhs comes to rupees 40,000. So 45,000 or 40,000, whichever is less, can be claimed as deduction. In our problem, we are going to claim 40,000 as deduction. The next one is donation to National Children's Fund, section 80G. So this donation comes under the category of without limit donation, and 100% of the donation can be claimed as deduction. That is, the entire amount of rupees 20,000 can be claimed as deduction, and the assessee is a disabled person. So initially I have already told that since the assessee is a disabled person, he can claim deduction under section 80U. So now he is going to claim deduction under section 80U. It is, in case of disability, standard deduction of rupees 75,000 is allowed. Add up all these deductions, the total amount of deductions comes to rupees 1,35,000. So deduct 1,35,000 from 4,40,000 to get the total income of rupees 3,05,000.